Beyond Meat, one of the most growing stocks in 2020 already, and the numbers are absolutely insane. Just in 4 trading days, the stock went up 44% and the stock grew more than 50% just in 2020. And we're just starting in 2020, and therefore let's have a look what really drives the stock up, and if it's really founded reasons that it goes up and really burned short sellers to ground. Let's roll.
Wolf of Dubai.
Let's go directly into the stock, because this is the most important here. As of this recording, this morning on Wall Street, the stock is down about 4 to 5%, which is normal, guys. Okay, just go back one step, because usually when investors see this kind of increase of stock price, they can get greedy, and we know the greedy ones later on will lose on Wall Street. And there is another reason why the stock is down. There is one down rating from a very, let's say, proper and well-known analyst house, which is called Bernstein, and they downgraded the stock. They said, hey, at these valuations, it's really hard to justify the stock price right now, and therefore be careful. And you know, this plus general profit taking from the table after such a run in the just so few days in 2020, it's just normal and shouldn't be a way to panic. So if you're there for the long run, just stay in the stock. Don't get up and down in this kind of trading days. This is totally normal and belongs to the Wall Street and traders as day and night. So let's jump directly into the stock. So we can see here about in the beginning of January, the stock went up until the 14th of January about 67%. This is an increase that some companies make over 2, 3, 4 years. If it's a growth company, you are happy that this kind of growth is happening during maybe 1 year, you know? But within just a couple of days, this is really interesting, and there are profound reasons for this increase. If we see the whole scenario, you know, 3 months ago, we was around the same levels as now. So, you know, from October till Jan, nothing changed in the between. We had just a long down road here until the beginning of Jan, until we spiked. If we taking even 6 months, you can see that there's the huge spike here in Jan. We came from originally after the IPO, and on the IPO date, we went up 160%. And on July 28, we had around the highs of 222. Now a market capitalization of 6.87. And you see how far it goes. Just a few days back, I made another video about the stock, and we were just at $5.9 billion valuation, stock valuation. This is going fast and crazy, guys. Therefore, make sure to smash that like button for the algorithm, and also smash that subscribe button just to not miss any of these daily vlogs that I'm doing on the stock market to make you the better investor. Now, let's jump into why this stock is going up. So jumping here into the main meat, we can see that there is a couple of reasons for this gain, and three of them we will go into detail. So first of all, obviously, even though it's a very unique product, very unique company, there is competition out there. Even I think one competitor, it's called Tiger Foods, they were investor first in Beyond Meat. They saw the potential, they went out as an investor, and they had around 6 or 7%. So not a very microscopic stake, a quite significant stake. And they saw the opportunity of this plant-based meat and open its new product. And another competitor, which fueled this kind of rally just now is Impossible Burger. Now, Impossible Burger, they are also producing this meat plant-based and subsidized regular meat. And we can see here that actually on the 7th of Jan, the Impossible Burger said they will not, cannot produce enough burgers to support the need of McDonald's. Now you can imagine that for McDonald's, one of the biggest fast food chains that producing millions or even billions of burgers per day, and if you can secure this customer as Beyond Meat, they are just making currently a Canada a test phase, and I can tell you if this is happening for Beyond Meat, it's huge. And if other competitors cannot keep up with the quantity out there, this is something that is really to watch, and I cannot be mad on the stockholders and the bulls that jump into Beyond Meat and push the stock just within one day 12.5% up, and in the next couple of days even 40% higher. Now, the second biggest reasons. Now, as you can imagine, this growth story, if you have seen 160% in the first trading day after the IPO, the short sellers come up. So the short sellers usually pick up stocks that they think that the stock price will go down. They are basically renting the stock, okay? Then they are selling it. They are paying every month's rent, a very small amount, but they actually sell the stock for, let's say, $500, and they believe that the stock goes down so they can buy it back for $200, make $300 on the stock profit, and give the stock back to the financial institution. Now, but what happens if the stock goes the other way around? It goes up, then of course the short sellers are really, really scared that it goes up and up and up and up, and they have to buy the stock back in the very high price range and will have an incredible loss. That's why sometimes when the stock goes up very fast, they say, hey, got it, let's close the deal, let's buy back the share, which gives the share on the market in even higher push to the new highs. And this is what happened in Beyond Meat. Now, I have a shocker here. You know, maybe if you follow my other videos about Tesla, which is one of the most shortest stock on the stock market with about 25%, Beyond Meat was 40% of all stocks that was out there was short sold. So you can see how big this bet against Beyond Meat is, and is bigger is the push and the short squeeze here. Apparently, $500 million was lost for short sellers just because of this beautiful trading days, and therefore, you know, I believe that short selling is a very hard thing to do. You have to really be good with timing, good with market, good with the good about having good research about this stock, because in the end you have to have tick so many boxes, and still if you're ticking all these boxes, the stock for some reason can go up, like we have seen just bad competitor news, and that's why so much money was lost. This is basically the source by S3 Partners that made a huge nice research about that I read for you to have you the summarized version here in this vlog. Now, the last reason I think the stock keeps on stable for now is there is, if we going back to the stock, there is around the October last year period where the lockup period for a long-time investor prior to the IPO was expiring and many people were selling, and but there was the management, the CEO, they were not selling. So this is obviously a very good sign, a trust sign into the company, especially if the company stock price rise so high and the CEO and other chief executives can make so much money on their stock options or stocks that they have for very maybe a couple of few dollars, and then can sell it for $200 or more, and it's a good sign that the senior management didn't sold the stock, and this I think keeps the stock level on this prices. So I believe, you know, this is absolutely and positive sign for the stock, for the management, for the future vision of the company, that the staff, the senior staff, are believing in the vision, the management execution, and of course in the product as well.